You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host, and I have a friend of mine, Steve Murphy, fellow Rotarian.
Hey, Mark.
Good to see you. Steve is the development director for the House of Possibilities, which
That's
is
right.
right over on 138, right near Stonehill. It's behind the Morrow Elementary School, which used to be Morrow Hall when I went to Stonehill.
That's right.
Okay, it's a house of possibilities. It's cool.
That's right.
So you are having a nice event coming up, but we'll talk about House of Possibilities first. Tell us a little bit about House of Possibilities and what it stands for.
Well, back in about 2000, our founder, Paula Cavallis, had a developmentally disabled child. And she realized that there wasn't any great overnight respite care for severely developmentally disabled children. So she thought an overnight respite program would be great. So she started to take steps forward to create that. And so now we're in a position where we do have a facility. It's three floors. We have the lower floor, the main floor, and the second floor. And we have a number of children that want to come and use our facility, special children.
So you just told us about the facility. I said, I didn't realize that was actually right there inside that house. I didn't know that.
Well, you're not alone. A lot of people didn't realize that. And the facility itself, it was interesting because Paula went over to Stonehill and spoke with Stonehill and said, do you have any land available that we could use to do this, to make a place where children could go? And initially, Stonehill didn't have the land, but fortunately, about a couple weeks later, they called her back and said, yeah, we found a piece
nice.
Right next to Morrow Hall. So at that point, she started the construction, and with a lot of helpful people and funds that were donated, she was able to build the facility, and it opened in 2009 or 10.
Yeah. So talk about the overnight respite program. Tell us, you know, how it works, you know, how many I have info here about weekend nights per year and how long people might stay.
Well, when it first started, we had a number of families that brought their special child there for the first time. And when you have 24/7 with a special child,
yeah.
You wonder what the impact is going to be on that child the next day. Well, when many of the parents came back, the children didn't want to leave.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the beginning of something special. And so we on weekends now, alternating weekends, we will have 10 girls one Saturday night, 10 boys the next Saturday night. We alternate that through the month. We also do it during school vacations, and we also do it on holidays.
Well, I know dealing, and you've been through this before too, when you have an elderly parent and you have to care for them, you need a break, okay? I had luckily had some caregivers that helped out with Dad. But children, you know, with developmental disabilities or anybody, when people are caregivers and their family members, they need a break.
And that was a big part of it because Paula felt that she saw in herself and in other people that there was not that time to rest, to get relief, to spend time with her husband, to spend time with the other children. And she knew that that wasn't just her family. So she created this so that the parents can have 24 hours to go to dinner, to go to a movie, to spend that special time with their other children who have to give up a great deal when they have a special child in the family, though they all love that special child.
So what do the children do while they're there overnight or and then the parents and the family members?
Well, the children come and it's wonderful because we don't determine what type of disability. We accept all disabilities
mm-hmm.
there, except for the very few that you can accept. And so when they come, they make friendships. That's very important, and you see that when you're there. They participate in many programs and activities, both on campus and off campus, meeting the campus of Hope, the House of Possibilities. And they're involved, and they grow as human beings. To the point they can grow. And their families, they go home and they rest. And that 24-hour rest allows them to come back and be able to be a better parent to that special child who they love so very much.
Priceless. So let's get to the gala because I got the 5-minute queue. We're probably at 4 minutes left. Believe it or not, you and I can talk forever.
That's right.
Talk about the gala that's coming up on June 14th.
June 14th at the Four Point Sheraton in Norwood. We will be having our 8th annual gala, and we have a number of people that are coming, many, many people. We're very fortunate to have Ronan Tynan for, I think it's the third or fourth time, the Irish tenor. He will be there. Now, for those of you who don't know, Ronan Tynan is a Paralympian,
yeah,
as well as a doctor, as well as an Irish tenor, as well as a recording artist. So he is wonderful with the special children. And they're on stage with him, and there's nothing more moving than to see that. And there'll be a cocktail hour, there'll be a dinner, there's a silent auction, there's a live auction. And anyone who experiences this evening is experiencing something that they only will find once in a lifetime unless they return the next year, which we hope they will.
And you have a good guy, you have Fox 25 anchor Gene Levanchi, who's the host.
He's been with us and he's always there and he never lets us down. He does a tremendous job, and it's an exciting evening because we have all the donors, the sponsors, the supporters, the families, the children. Everybody's rushing around and moving around, but at the same time enjoying and appreciating what HOPE, the House of Possibility, stands for.
So it sounds like it's going to be a great evening. I'm going to assume, because I haven't been, about it's moving to begin with, because it helps children.
That's right, and you feel it. You feel it in your heart when you're there. I did. I've been there a few times to the gala, and it's just very moving.
And it all goes back to Paula, who started it 10
years
ago, right?
That's right, she started. She put her whole life into it, and her family has put their whole life into it. And she deserves a great deal of compliments for everything she's done. And she's the last person that wants to hear that, but there are so many people that appreciate what she's done for these children, her own and so many more.
So tell us how to get the tickets. We got 2 minutes left. So the website, the phone number, the contact person.
All right. The website is houseofpossibilities.org. The phone number is 508-205-0555. 508-205-0555. And you can ask for Steve Murphy. You can ask for Mike Sanderson. You can ask for Christine Hart. We'll get it done. And the one important thing that we want to tell everybody in Brockton is that along with our gala, along with what I've described, we're here to help the people in Brockton. There are families in Brockton that don't know, and in the communities around Brockton, that don't know about the House of Possibilities. They don't know it's available to their children, and they don't know it's available to them as parents. And we want them to know, and that's a big part of why I'm here today.
Well, we're going to bring you back. And we're going to try to go over there with the camera, and we'll show them. Okay, we'll figure out how to get the right permissions and go over there and show them what you have to offer. So, Steve, you're always doing good things. Thank you for coming on.
Thanks to you, Mark. You're always there for us.
Glad to. You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.